Hi dear Aquarius, a very very good evening to you guys. This is Anjali Tarot and this is a journal of reading for all the Aquarius Sun, Moon, Venus, Rising out there, okay? And so this is a reading from 20th of June till 30th of June, okay? Keep this in mind that these are journal of readings. This might or might not be your story, okay? And the roles can be reversed anytime, okay? So let's start with your reading, Aquarius. Yeah. So let's see, what's your partner's current energy? Aquarius, your partner's current energy right now is, let's see, your partner's current energy right now is Two of Cups. Aquarius, I feel like your partner is feeling some kind of soulmate connection, some kind of loving and caring connection, or it might also be possible that they are feeling this connection with the universe, or might be possible that they are feeling this connection with themselves. Okay, I'll check it out. I'll clarify this card in their current energy. But most of, for intuitively, I'm feeling like this person is feeling really happy from within. Okay, whatever they are doing, they are happy from within. This is the situation here. They are content and they are not, you know, acting like a fool or being very desperate. This person is typically right now very content with their life. They are, you know, in a happy zone, soulful zone basically. Let's clarify. Queen of Swords, Ace of Wands and the Eight of Swords. I feel like this person is, you know, hiding their feelings, concealing their feelings. This person is very very clear about their intentions. They're not playing any kind of hide and seek, and they're, you know, talking to you very openly and honestly about that, what they want from you, what they want from this connection. And in this pursuit of telling you what they want from you, I feel like this person is getting a little rude with you. Okay, so don't take their rudeness as a sign that they don't need you. No, this is not the situation. They still care for you, they still love you, and they still have lots of emotions for you. I feel like this person is, you know, very very clear that they want a new beginning in this connection. They want a passionate start in this connection, and they want to come out of this mental conflict. Okay, I feel like this person is in some kind of mental conflict, in some kind of mental jail right now, and this person wants to end this mental conflict and they want to start this connection all over again, and they want to start the connection from scratch right now, and they're very very clear about their intentions regarding this connection, that you are their true soulmate, that you and them are soulmates, that you and them are still very very good partners. This is the situation, okay? This is their current energy. Let's see what's your current energy, Aquarius. Your current energy right now is, Aquarius, let's see. Your current energy right now is, Aquarius. Let's see what's your current energy. Four of Pentacles. Again, you got the past energy. You got the previous energy. What was your energy in the previous reading? If you remember, that is your same energy that you're carrying right now as well. You're trying to control each and everything. You're very possessive. You are very obsessive. And you're trying to control this person. You're being a control freak right now. This is the situation here. Okay. Might be you're trying to control your emotions. Might be you're trying to control what you are doing from a very long time. Okay. So I feel like most of the times, I feel like you're trying to control this particular person. And that's why this person is right now feeling like a conflict. That's why this person wants to end this, you know, conflicting situation and start this connection all over again. Let's start. Let's clarify the Four of Pentacles in your current energy. Why are you such a control freak, Aquarius? You have to leave this. You know, you have to leave this situation where you are acting like a control freak, where you are, you know, trying to control the other person's life. This is not happening. This is not the right thing to do. So I feel like you are right now trying to control your emotions, trying to hide your emotions, and you are very obsessive. You are very possessive about somebody because you feel like this person makes you really very very happy. This person, whenever they are with you, or whenever you even think about this person, that give you goosebumps. And I was saying goosebumps, I'm really sorry. So this person gives you goosebumps and this person makes you really very very happy. You are somewhat confused. Okay, you're juggling between the situation where you are like, whether I should talk to this person or not, whether I should reach this person or not. But deep down, you want this person in your life for a long-term committed relationship, okay, or marriage. So this is the situation here. That's why you're just trying to control your emotions, because you are feeling like you are confused, you are conflicted. and that's why you are trying to control your emotions, conceal your emotion, hide your emotions from this particular person. Might be you're telling them that I don't give a shit to this connection, but deep down you give a lot of shit. You give a lot of fuck to this connection, literal fuck as well. Enjoy. No, I'm just kidding. So let's see what this person feels for you, Aquarius. Their feelings for you. Let's see what this person feels for you, Aquarius. Their feelings for you. My God, Three of Swords. This person is completely heartbroken. This person, I feel like, Aquarius, you broke their heart. You broke their heart, you broke their trust. You did something rubbish and that breaks their heart completely. So they are deeply sad, deeply depressed right now. For some of you, this person might be dealing with some kind of heart diseases and might be they are going through some kind of surgery for some of you. But for most of you, I feel like this person is very, very depressed, very, very sad. And they are, you know, right now they are in a depressing phase, very, very sad phase because they are heartbroken, completely shattered by something that happened to them. Let's clarify why they are feeling like this. So I feel like this person is heartbroken because you did something to them, or you broke up with them, or because you are, you know, acting like very, very, acting like a control freak, acting like crazy. That's why this person was might be, expecting something else from you, and you are doing the reverse. This is the thing. Queen of Wands, Seven of Cups, and the Seven of Pentacles and the Justice could be dealing with a Libra. And I feel like you could be dealing with any earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well. These are coming, the signs here. So I feel like this person is heartbroken because this person was very, very passionate about you. This person was waiting for you, waiting for the right time, or this person was waiting for you to know, you know, to, you know, go towards them and talk to them and serve justice to this connection. So there is some kind of injustice that is happening in this connection. Either you or them are doing that, and that's why this person is completely heartbroken, because they are feeling that there's injustice in this connection. There is no equal give and take in this energy, in this connection. I am putting all the efforts, I am putting all the energy from my side. The Aquarius is not giving a fuck, and that's making them completely heartbroken. It could also be reverse, okay? They're completely shattered right now, and I feel like they are, you know, shutting the doors of their heart because something hurt them really badly. Really, really, really badly. Gosh. Let's see what they want from you, Aquarius. What this person wants from you, let's see. Five of Swords. This person wants you to come out of this conflicting state of mind, you know, to leave this mind games. This person wants you to, you know, come out of this ego battle thing. So I feel like you are giving more attention to your ego rather than this connection. And that's why these ego battles are going on between you guys. Might be you're winning the battle, Aquarius. Might be you're winning the battle, but you're losing the person. This is a situation where this person is feeling like this, you know, conflict should end. This ego battle should end. This is the situation here. And that's making this connection more and more conflicted, more and more complicated with each passing day. Because there's some kind of ego battle going on between you guys, or might be you are right now acting like crazy, acting like weird, because you are trying to control them, control their life, control their emotions. That's not possible at all. This is the Knight of Cups and the King of Pentacles and the Hanged Man. Okay, so I feel like this person wants you to come out of this conflicting situation and, you know, show that you love them. They want you to show them that you love them, that you care for them. They want you to be happy. They want you to be stable-minded. They want you to be practical. And they want you to see their perspective as well, to see their point of view as well, okay? I feel like you are just ignoring their point of view. You are, you know, not ready to listen to their point of view. So this person wants you basically to come out of this situation where there's ego battle things going on, mind games going on. And this person wants you to realize that this connection is not about ego games. This connection is not about mind games. This connection is all about love. This connection is all about care, healing. This person wants you to act maturely and act with practicality. Not just like a fool, like I just want this to happen. This should be like that only. Otherwise, I'm going to leave you. Or otherwise, I'm just, you know, not going to give a shit to this connection. That this is not the way you should deal with them, okay? And this person wants you to just relax, take a step back and analyze everything. Okay, and you know, to see their point of view as well, to listen to their point of view as well. So this is the situation. This is what they want from you, Aquarius. I can see you are doing something mischievous. So I am telling you again and again that energies could be reversed. You can tell me in the comment section if this is your energy and that was their energy. Okay, let's see. Let's see what to expect from this person till 30th of June. Aquarius, let's see what to expect from this person till 30th of June. 30th. Queen of Pentacles. So I feel like this person as of now is not coming towards you, Aquarius, in my opinion, because this person is right now going through some kind of healing process and they are busy working on themselves, their self-healing, self-love, self-care, and I feel like this person is going through some kind of shitty situation. This person is going through some kind of, you know, a sad situation, depressed situation, and they are trying to come out of that situation and they are just trying to heal themselves. They are trying to act mature and act as much as practical as possible. And I feel like this person is just right now needs a break. And that's why might be they are not going to, you know, talk to you, or they are not going to ignore you basically. You guys will communicate with each other, but there will be maturity in the communication. There will be, you know, practicality in the communication. There is no love situation here. Give me a second. So I feel like there is practicality, there is maturity and there is self-love, self-healing. Let's clarify further. There will be communication between you guys. I'm not saying there will be no communication at all, but you just have to take care about your words, about your nature, about what you're doing right now to them. This is the situation. Star, you could be dealing with another Aquarius, Ace of Pentacles and the Sun. You could be dealing with a Leo here. So I feel like this person right now wants to self-heal, self-love, because they're very, very hopeful and positive. They're very hopeful and positive about this connection, that this connection will start all over again and there will be, you know, a brand new beginning in this connection. There will be love in this connection and there will be, you know, the past will be in the past and we will start again and there will be lots of happiness. There will be, you know, hell lot of happiness. This is their energy. So right now they are backing off. Right now they are holding back because they are feeling someday everything is going to be fine between you guys, and someday you are going to be really the person you were used to be when this relationship started, and you guys will be, you know, happy-go-lucky again. This is the situation here. So I feel like this person will come to you whenever they are going to feel like you are changing or the situations are changing. Now I can go back to my Aquarius and I can talk to them. This is the situation here, okay? So I feel like although they are going to talk to you, but there will be no, you know, there will be no love talks, or you can say romantic talks or something like that. I'm not seeing romance anywhere in this reading, but romantic, gestures anywhere in this reading. But yes, care and love is here, and that too, caring love is there, you can say, okay? So thank you so much, Aquarius, for tuning in. I hope this reading will give you some kind of insight regarding your love life, and this is your free will now, what kind of decision you want to take. Thank you so much. God bless you. Namaste. This is Anjali Tarot. Namaste.